Dream is not what you see in sleep. Dream is something that doesn't let you sleep. Namaste children. Have you heard these words before? Well, yes, you are absolutely correct. This is one of the quotes of the famous scientist and politician of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He was an Indian aerospace scientist and politician who served as the 11th president of India from 2002 to 2007. So children, today I am going to read you out Unit 4, I have done it, Section 1, The Missile Man, an interview with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I feel that we are very fortunate that we have a chapter in our literature book that is based upon the interview of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So without further ado, I'm going to read the chapter as well as some of the anecdotes which will make you respect this legend even more. All right, now let's get started. The Missile Man. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Popularly known as People's President, no words can describe and highlight the humility and charm of India's missile man, who has won millions of hearts around the world. Here are a few rare stories about Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam that will only make you respect this legend even more. The meaning of the word humility here means modest. He was down to earth. Once, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam rejected the suggestion to put broken glass pieces on the wall of a building that needed protection. This happened when Dr. Kalam was with the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO. His team was discussing options to secure the perimeter of a building that needed protection by fixing broken glass pieces on the upper edges of the walls. Dr. Kalam reportedly said, "If we do that, birds will not be able to perch on the wall." Perch means to rest. This shows that he was empathetic towards animals and birds. President Kalam was known to write his own thank you cards. As humble and generous the man he was, President Kalam was known to sign his own thank you cards with a short handwritten message, and he personalized them with his signature. Once, during an event, Dr. Kalam refused to sit on a chair that was designated for him, that was assigned for him, because the chair was larger in size than the other chairs. At a convocation, Dr. Kalam was the chief guest. There were 5 chairs on the stage. The center one was designated for Dr. Kalam. The other 4 for top university officials. Noticing his chair to be bigger in size than the others, Dr. Kalam refused to sit on it. No doubt, another chair was made available immediately for the honorable former president. How humble he was. This shows his humility. He was very modest. And the most important story of his contribution to India's space and defense programs. Dr. Kalam was one of the few scientists who started working with ISRO during the agency's early years. A church became the place of work for the handful of India's rocket scientists, including Dr. Kalam. And a nearby beach became the place where the rocket launch pad was set up. Cycles and bullock carts were used back in the 1970s and 1980s to transport rocket parts and satellites. Dr. Kalam was the director of the project that indigenously developed
the SLV-3 space launch vehicle and also the PSLV, which was used in the Moon and the Mars mission. In 1980, SLV-3 successfully injected the Rohini satellite into a near-Earth orbit and made India an exclusive member of the Space Club. After working with ISRO, Dr. Kalam took up responsibilities for developing indigenous means native, guided missiles at the DRDO, which led to the development of Agni and Prithvi missiles. He also led the Pokhran second nuclear test that made India a nuclear power. I have done it, the missile man, an interview with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. It was indeed a great honor when Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam agreed to interact with us despite his busy schedule. In this interview, the missile man shares his experience and views on science, education and future India. Could you please narrate one incident that proved to be a turning point in your life, which eventually shaped your profession? Turning point here means something which changed your life. An important point. APJ Abdul Kalam. It happened at the age of 10 when I was studying in class 5. I had a teacher, Shri Siva Subramanyam Iyer. He was one of the best teachers in our school. One day, he was teaching about bird's flight. He drew a diagram of a bird on the blackboard, depicting the wings, tail, and the body structure with the head. He explained how birds create the lift and fly. He also explained how they change direction while flying. At the end of the class, he wanted to know whether we had understood how birds fly. I said that I had not. Many other students also said that they had not understood. He was not upset by our response. Instead, he took us to the seashore. Seashore means land along the sea. That evening, the whole class was on the seashore. Birds were flying and chirping sweetly. He showed the seabirds flying in a formation of 10 to 20 numbers. We saw the marvelous formation of birds and we were all amazed. He showed the birds and asked us to see what it looks like when the birds fly. We saw the wings being flapped. He asked us to look at the tail portion and at the combination of flapping wings and twisting tail. We noticed closely and found that here the meaning of flapped means it is related to a bird when a bird moves its wing up and down when flying or preparing to fly. So we noticed closely and found that the birds in that condition flew in the direction they want. Then he asked us a question, where is the engine of the bird? And how is it powered? A bird is powered by its own life and the motivation of what it wants. All these things were explained to us within 15 minutes. We all understood the whole bird dynamics with a practical example. Dynamics means the science of force involved in movement. From that day, I thought that my future study had to be with reference to flight and flight sciences. One evening after the classes, I asked the teacher, "Sir, please tell me how to progress further in learning flight sciences." He patiently explained to me that I should complete class 8, go to high school, and then I should go to college. That may lead me to my education of flight. This advice, the bird flying exercise given by my teacher and the encouragement given to me to ask questions really gave me a goal and mission for my life. When I went to college, I took physics. When I went for engineering in Madras Institute of Technology, I took aeronautical engineering. Thus, my life was transformed as a rocket engineer, aerospace engineer, and technologist. So, his teacher had an important role in shaping his future. We all regard you as the undisputed father of the Indian missile program. Please enlighten us on the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, IGMDP, and five of its major projects. In 1983, IGMDP envisaged development of five missile systems. Prithvi, surface-to-surface missile with 150 km range, Akash, medium-range surface-to-air missile, 24 km of range, Trishul, short-range quick-reaction surface-to-air missile with 8 to 10 km of range, Nag, fire-and-forget anti-tank missile with 4 km of range. Agni, technology demonstrator of a long-range strategic missile system. During the last 25 years, two strategic missile systems have been fully developed and they have been produced in quantity and deployed. Deployed means they are moved into a position where they are ready to use for an action. Akash has been ordered by the Air Force. A number of variants of Prithvi and Agni have also been developed. We are often troubled by the inequality of access to education. How can this be resolved? How can the students help in solving this problem? Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam answered, "This can be resolved only by enhancing. Enhancing means increasing the number of seats in professional courses like medical, pharma, and management, as has been done in the case of engineering. Today, a number of engineering seats are vacant. Students have a choice for getting the best education. Students can also solve the problem by going for distant education programs. Distant means private, which will reduce the load, the burden on classroom education. Institutions have to ensure that in distance education programs, the content quality is high and appropriately supplemented with contact programs." So Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam suggested that by enhancing the number of seats and by the students can also go for distant education. This can solve the problem of inequality of access to education. Atom is usually associated with an atom bomb, destruction. Please enlighten us on the brighter side of nuclear energy, how it is used for creation and development. Enlighten means to give someone great knowledge and understanding about a subject or a situation. Nuclear energy can be used for power generation, medical application, and irradiation of seeds for quality agriculture. So, we know that nuclear energy is associated with destruction, but it can be also used for power generation, medical application, and irradiation of seeds for quality agriculture. Interviewer, next question. How do you see India by 2020? I visualize the following distinctive profile of India by 2020. Distinctive means different. A nation where the rural and urban divide has reduced to a thin line. Rural and urban means rural areas and urban areas has reduced to a thin line means there should not be much difference. Progress should be made in rural areas also. A nation where there is an equitable distribution and adequate access to energy and quality water. Equitable means equal distribution. Every state has equal distribution to energy and quality of water. A nation where agriculture, industry and service sectors work together in symphony. Symphony means in peace. A nation where education with value system is not denied to any meritorious candidate because of societal or economic discrimination. Denied means not given. Fine. So on the basis of social or economic discrimination, nobody should be denied education. A nation which is the best destination for the most talented scholars, scientists and investors. A nation where the best of healthcare is available to all. A nation where the government is responsive. Responsive means responsible. Transparent, accountable. Transparent means accountable. The people of the country should be able to know what the government is doing, and corruption free. A nation where poverty has been totally eradicated. Eradicated means removed. Illiteracy removed and crimes against women and children are absent and no one in the society feels alienated. Alienated means feeling isolation. A nation that is prosperous, healthy, secure, devoid of terrorism. There's no terrorism. Peaceful and happy and continuous with a sustainable growth path. Sustainable means balanced. A nation where there is prosperity, which is devoid of terrorism, and peaceful and happy and continuous with a sustainable, balanced growth path. A nation that is one of the best place to live in and is proud of its leadership. Interviewer, we know that you are a connoisseur of classical Carnatic music. How and when do you develop this interest? This I had developed when I was in St. Joseph College, Trichy. Particularly, I enjoyed the imaginative alapanas of music exponents like M.S. Subbalakshmi and Semaguddi Srinivasa Iyer. My friend Santhanam and myself were regular listeners in Thiruvayur Thyagaraja Festival. While we were studying in St. Joseph College, Trichy, we used to discuss the ragas for week in the hostel after listening to the music in Thyagaraja Festival. Any message for the future citizens of India? Friends, I would like to assert for the future citizens of India that no youth today needs to fear about the future. How? If you have an aim in life, realize that time spent cannot be recovered. The precious time has to be used for achieving the goal. Have the confidence to win, to defeat problems and succeed. Have a righteous heart. You will definitely succeed in all your missions.